been about a year since I did my Golden Chaos customization video, and I think it's time to spice up my touch bar a little bit. I had seen AquaTouch in the Better Touch Tool forums, but I had never really given it a real chance. I've been using it for the past 2 weeks, and I'd like to give you guys my thoughts. My name is Jake from Fish Tech, and this is my review on the AquaTouch preset for the touch bar. Do you want to become a part of my touch bar? If you subscribe today, I'll get a notification. It'll make me really happy. Now, there are a couple things that we should go over before we get directly into this review. And the first thing is that this version of AquaTouch is a bit unstable. I had a good conversation with the developer. They are actively updating this preset all the time, so you can expect new changes coming soon, bug fixes all the time. So I'm encouraged that this is going to get to a point where it would be 100% recommendation from me. As of right now, I still love it. I'm just gonna be eagerly waiting some of the bug fixes that are gonna turn this thing into just like an amazing preset that everybody should potentially have. And we'll get into those bugs later and how they might deter you from using it right now, but let's get into the features that AquaTouch offers you. AquaTouch is an impressive, feature-rich preset for Better Touch Tool. It has a clean style, allowing it to seamlessly integrate with Apple's native touch bar environment. The main design concepts for AquaTouch are pretty powerful and innovative. Who needs volume and brightness buttons on the keyboard? Not us. We have gesture controls to take care of that, so why even bother taking up the space there? AquaTouch has six main modes that you can be in. The first one is Quick Media. This is used for all things media. You can play slash pause your music, go to the next track or a previous one, and it works with web browsers, iTunes, and Spotify. You can tap on each individual app within here to open up extra menus and options. There's also Quick Schedules. This tab shows your events for the day and reminders due that week. It also has the date, time, and weather, which can be long pressed for a week's worth displayed. Moving on to Quick Controls. There are lots of nice controls to access here, with highlights including Sleep Your Mac, Connect to AirPods, which is actually not working right now, that's a known issue, and Game Mode, which we'll get into soon. Then we got Quick Apps. We got the active apps on the left that you can use to switch between, and then we have some goodies in the middle, such as opening up the Finder or creating some new documents. AquaTouch also features extension layouts. This is when the default layout does a pretty good job for the app, but could use a few additional features. You can click the button next to the left of the control strip to access these additional features. And finally, you have unsupported apps. AquaTouch can't support every app there is, and when it doesn't support it, it looks like this. It still lets you use your hand gestures to control the volume and brightness, and you can always access the four buttons on the right side to get the quick media and quick apps and all the other layouts. And that leads us into game mode. I actually love game mode. It is super cool. You get your battery displayed, the time, you get your CPU temperature, and then you also get what your fan speeds are at. As well as touching the pink button on the right side will allow you to turn off game mode, add your game to game mode, or you can toggle the AquaTouch touch bar. AquaTouch offers some pretty awesome support when you're using Safari. As you can see, I'm in the Gmail, and there are just so many extra little things that are there to make your life easier. You get the read and the compose sections, and it's just like, there's so much stuff here, especially in the Google Sheets. It's a lot of common things, and I don't memorize the keyboard shortcuts for Google Sheets. Who does that? I don't know. But these touch bar buttons make things a lot more simpler in your life. You don't have to go digging through all these settings. They're just right there, ready for you to use. And then SoundCloud also has a nice setup. These aren't the only supported apps, but these were the ones that I was like, wow, these are really nice. I really like these. Now, unfortunately, if you're a Chrome user, there is not as much widespread support for Chrome, but you still do get a YouTube widget, which is pretty nice. It's definitely very responsive. It's not as inclusive as the Safari YouTube widget, but it gets the job done. I can live my life with this. But for real, if you're a Safari user, you are going to absolutely love this preset and all the features that it has to offer. All right, so we're gonna go over one of the bugs that AquaTouch has that is pretty bothersome to me, and it's one of the only major flaws that I really see, and it's when you're switching apps, and it doesn't really switch apps very well. So you'll see we're in Google Sheets. If I click on Google Sheets, now I'm in the Google Sheets widget. If I want to switch to YouTube, you would think that it's gonna switch to the YouTube widget, but it doesn't. It actually goes to the default touch bar. So I now have to click the AquaTouch touch bar button and then click the YouTube widget button. And now I'm in the YouTube widget and it's free. It's nice. I love that you can do that. But then when it's time to switch back, I would love it if it would just go straight into the widget so I don't have to click another button there. And it's also the same thing. So if I'm in the now playing section of this preset, and then I switch to the YouTube, it goes to the default touch bar, which I don't want. You know, if I'm in the now playing section, I would prefer to either stay in the now playing section when I change apps or go into the deeper settings that I would typically want, you know, which for this case would be the YouTube widget. It either has to, you know, it shouldn't go to the default. And this is just something that's incredibly difficult to program into Better Touch Tool, the automatic switching, especially when considering specific websites that you're using. But I believe that this is something that the developer is actively working on to fix to make sure the correct thing is brought up in the touch bar when you're switching apps. So this is just something that they're gonna have to flush out as they go. And I'm pretty confident that eventually it will get there. Now there's also a preset for the Finder window. It's got the arrows go back and forth. It's got some lookup options and some different folder options. And it's just a really nice looking layout that it has. And there are plenty of Adobe applications that are supported. And these are no joke. These are legit buttons to have up there and they are actually useful. You'll see here, it's got Adobe Photoshop, Illustrator, and After Effects. And in After Effects, there's keyframes, there's Easy Ease, and I was like, oh, that is so helpful because I always have to dig. I don't use After Effects enough to like memorize the keyboard shortcuts. So I was just like, yes, I was so excited to have those right there. It just makes your life a lot easier. So when you first open up AquaTouch, what you're gonna initially wanna do is slide this bar over and you'll see some setup instructions, the usage manual, and some AquaTouch settings. You're definitely gonna wanna do the setup instructions. That'll get your Better Touch Tool settings all set up so everything is ready to go. Definitely read the usage manual because that will give you a lot of information actually on some of the design principles and the layouts and why everything was done the way it was. The next thing that you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna open up Safari and then you're gonna go to the Develop tab. And then you wanna make sure that Allow JavaScript from Apple Events is selected. That's gonna allow a lot of the features from the AquaTouch preset to interact with your Safari browser. Now, this last step we're gonna do is in order to get the game mode working, which is a super cool feature, but in order to get it working, you have to do a few things in your terminal. So you're going to open up your terminal. Yours might look a little bit different than mine, but that's perfectly okay. You're still gonna type the exact same stuff as me. So the first terminal command that we're gonna input is xcode /base --install. And this is only if you do not have Xcode installed. If you have Xcode installed on your computer, you don't actually have to do this command. But if you don't have Xcode, just type that in, hit return. You'll see that I get an error because I already have it installed. And then the second command that you're gonna wanna input is sudo gem install istat. And you're just gonna hit enter. It's gonna ask for your computer password once you do that. And then it should install istats. And then to make sure that it is working, you can just come into your terminal and you can type in istats, hit enter, and you'll see a bunch of cool information. You'll get your CPU temperature, your fan speeds, your battery health, all that cool stuff. And that's where the information on the touch bar is actually coming from. So you might be wondering, am I going to make this my everyday touch bar setup? The short answer is yes, I am. The long answer is yes, I am, but I'm going to make some modifications to it. If those modifications are something that you'd be interested in seeing, then drop a comment down below and we'll make a new video about it. For me right now, the setup is awesome, but it also needs some adjustments to make it a little bit more usable when you're switching apps, especially in the web browser. So that's what my main focus is going to be on, is kind of bringing it to something that's a little bit more user-friendly and a little bit simpler. So it's not as complex, it's a little more consistent. If you guys enjoyed this video, then give it a like and consider joining the Touch Bar squad on my own personal Touch Bar. If you didn't like it, that's totally okay. You can give it a dislike. All I ask is that you drop a comment down below saying what I could have done better so that my videos will continue to improve. That's all I got for today. Peace.